Seemingly out of nowhere today, we've got the revelation of a ton of new PlayStation 4 games, some smaller games, but I found a lot of these games rather interesting, and as we head into this heavy holiday period and fall period of big game releases, a lot of these titles are gonna get swept under the rug, so I wanted to mention them in a dedicated video because a lot of them look rather cool and a lot of them will be out relatively soon, so let's talk about them. We've got six games to go over, and first up, I want to start off with a roguelike action platformer in Neon Abyss. That's launching on the PlayStation 4 for sometime in 2020, and Neon Abyss is said to be a frantic roguelike action platformer featuring unlimited item synergies and unique dungeon evolving systems. Each of your raids diversifies the dungeon experience, and every choice you make alters the rule set of the dungeon. You will die a lot in the game, and every time you die, you're just a step closer to your ultimate goal to find the artifact to fulfill your any wishes. As far as the gameplay is concerned, it notes battle your way through an underworld eternally in flux, crush the new gods of Bitcoin and nightclubs, combine your loot, achieve awesome power, and find the cure for your immortal curse. During your journey, you will recover powerful items, find adorable pets, meet strangers, passerbys, and discover countless secrets. Of course, you will die often, but failure is just a chance to catch your breath before diving back in. As your experience grows, the entire dungeon will grow and evolve under your control. Eventually, you will master all the secrets and reach the darkest depths of the abyss. The game notes an evolving dungeon. There is a unique and expandable underworld. You can choose a personalized upgrade pad to expand your dungeon and unlock new rooms, bosses, items, special rules, and new endings. Unlimited item synergies with various builds, passive effects between items will stack and affect one another, and there is no limit to the number of effects you can apply to your character. No one knows what'll happen or what you'll create. The game also touts massive content, dynamically generated maps, over 400 items, dozens of monsters with different styles, and countless secrets ensure that every adventure is completely fresh. Pets hatching and evolving as you descend into the abyss, you'll find eggs you can take care of which will hatch into a random pet. Each pet has a special ability and most can evolve as you play. There's various minigames, multiple playable characters, neon gods, and an incredible soundtrack. Award-winning composer Min Hee, whose past credits include Princess Eunha, Rift, and How to Get Away with Murder, has composed a dark-style electronic soundtrack to fit in a war waged against neon gods. Again, Neon Abyss is scheduled for a PlayStation 4 release sometime in 2019, and it is coming from a Chinese developer, so I really want to see these Chinese developed games come out and see how they turn out, because they're creating some incredibly compelling games. However, we're just not seeing a ton of them be released. Alright, next up, we've got a very interesting basketball game, 3v3 basketball game, and Project Dunk is coming to the PlayStation 4. Kind of reminds me of Mario Hoops 3v3, but nonetheless, this one is coming from developer Giant Games, and it was announced at China Joy as well. The game notes, hit the court and take on the world here in the streets. On top of showing off your basketball skills, you can also utilize the gear made with top-notch technology to perform special moves. There is no rules, no boundaries, and all about winning. With the special design characters, you can perform various abilities and attack moves, including throwing a chair your opponent in wrestling style, remote controlling the basketball into the net, and even forcing the opponent out of the game from injuries. These guys are fearless and not afraid to fight on their turf. This one unfortunately doesn't have a release date, but we don't see a ton of arcade basketball games, so this is definitely filling a niche that I'm excited to check out. Again, hopefully it's out sometime in 2020. Next up, we have the roguelike game in Blazing Beaks. That's coming to the PlayStation 4. Once again, another title without an official release date. However, it's already been released on PC and it's been received very well over there, with an overall reception of 277 user reviews, 84% positive, and recent reviews have 25 reviews, and every single one of those reviews have been positive from a Steam user review standpoint. It notes, roguelite where too much greediness can be fatal, a colorful world with armed birds blazing their way through piles of mutants, monsters, and creepy creatures, lots of mysteries to unravel, secrets to discover, and levels to explore. The game notes a variety of different artifacts, you'll be tempted to take them, but doing so will make you really suffer. Story mode, plow your path through a whole host of enemies and wag them back to where they came from. Tournament mode, arena-based local multiplayer mode where your friendships will really be tested. Local co-op story mode, all the story mode carnage is even more fun when you play with a friend. At least that's what it notes. Great to see local cooperative play. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like it has online co-op, but the more games we see with cooperative play, the better it is, especially with local co-op play, as that has been a little bit of a dying breed in gaming. It also does note 8 playable characters, each with unique abilities, and that'll make gameplay even more versatile. Character mods, you can create your own own, share, and play with custom characters created by the community in hours upon hours of fun. Again, we don't have an official release date, but considering this one's already been released on PC and we have an English translation for it, hopefully it's out sooner rather than later. Next up, here's one that I think looks pretty cool. Side-scrolling beat-em-up in Wonder Blade is coming to the PlayStation 4. It's available now for smartphones. It'll be coming August 8th to PC and hopefully sometime soon on PlayStation 4 as well. The PC version is going into early access, and this game looks incredibly stylish, incredibly charming from a presentation standpoint, and it notes, what are you waiting for? Grab that trusty weapon of yours, free the princess, and save the world all before breakfast. What do you get when you cross a whimsical adventure, humorous characters, and combat to die for? Wonder Blade, an awesome experience you won't soon forget. The game touts a fascinating tale of butt-kicking love and woe that doesn't take itself too seriously. Spectacular combos, flashy finishing moves, and butter-smooth animation, a variety of stages and experiences, more than just whacking bad guys with a sword. Bosses, mini-bosses, big bad guys, and a little bad guy, oh my. Collectible outfits and weapons, unlock and upgrade badass skills as you level up, and that's just a taste of what the game has to offer. Obviously, being that this is originally a smartphone title, it's not like visually it's anything to write home about. However, it does have that charming visual style that even though technically it's not amazing, I do find it captivating from a presentation standpoint as well. Again, Wonder Blade will be out August 8th in early access on PC. Hopefully the PlayStation 4 version is due out before the end of the year. Next up, here's another really cool game. Robot-themed fighting game Metal Revolution is coming to the PlayStation 4. This is another title that has a unique premise coming from a Chinese studio in NEC Studios, and Metal Revolution is a new generation of fighting game. The minimalistic controls, deep gameplay, and the cyberpunk robot theme are designed to bring a fresh battle experience for the fighters who never flinch in the face of furious combat. Welcome to Metal Revolution. Again, very interesting from a stylization standpoint, as you have these very unique robots and mechs to play as. And it's how simple moves allow for creativity. Breaking from traditional fighting game controls, players can easily master the basic moves, and even newcomers can also use cool moves. And stylistically, it looks incredibly flashy from a combat standpoint. It also notes defensive blocking, explosive ultimates, and each character has a unique ultimate art, a gorgeous way to end your opponent, and the one that we saw looked really good. And it looked a little vicious. As far as game modes in the title go, you've got arena rank play, quick match, friend mode, local mode, arcade mode, training mode. And after the release of the game, they also noted that they're gonna add more skins and stages, more battle modes, story mode. In the story mode, you can explore the stories behind each character in the game, their connections to the other characters, and discover the intrigue hidden behind the fighting contest. And players can also earn coins by completing the in-game, which can then be used to buy in-game items. You can also purchase all the characters and their unique skins. That sounds like there's gonna be some microtransactions in the game. That is a little bit of a bummer, but nonetheless, fighting games these days, if you don't have microtransactions, it seems like you're doing something a little wrong at that point. But still a bummer nonetheless. We don't have an official release date for this one, but I imagine it won't be out this year, hopefully sometime in 2020. And lastly, this one is really up my alley. We've got the cyberpunk themed visual novel in Went Refractor. I know a lot of you guys aren't into visual novels. If you aren't, go play Danganronpa and maybe that'll get you into the genre. But Went Refractor is a cyberpunk dystopia visual novel with unique puzzles after the end of the world in an isolated city relying on high-tech technology to survive. As one of the inquisitors in this deeply hierarchical society, you are a girl who can read minds by hacking brain implants. While investigating a case, you bump into something that has been carefully hidden. Step by step, you get closer to danger and perhaps the truth. The game's key features tout seek the answer to everything, walk through every zone of the city to chase down all possible clues, visit people and other entities in the city to investigate the details of the case. Make your choices. History is full of examples of people who play it too safe. They live their lives without taking risks for something better. Be a defender of both law and order, or try to break the rules to pursue true human nature. And lastly, hack into minds to unravel the truths. Keep an eye on what everyone is talking about around. You have to know how to talk to people, draw people out, and unveil their humanity. Unravel is the key information hidden in each scene and dialogue. Choose the appropriate piece of information to help you breach people's psychological barriers and dive into their inner realms. When Refractor's Steam page is up right now and it is due out Q3 2019, we'll see if that release window hits and we'll see if that's just for the PC version, but nonetheless, this is one for you visual novel guys out there like me. If you played games like Danganronpa or Zero Escape and you dug that, I think When Refractor might be something right up your alley. It's got a great cyberpunk setting, and I'm excited to see how that one turns out. And that's gonna conclude this video. Again, a ton of new PlayStation 4 games are being announced. We've got 6 big reveals here. And even though while I wouldn't say they're these big budget gigantic games, they're games that I find relatively captivating, so I thought I would bring them to your guys' attention. That's gonna conclude this video. Do sound off with all of your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching. Thank you.